Hi people, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and today I'm going to talk to you about the UGC NET paper 1 which happened on 6th of December in the first shift. So I tried to analyze the paper for you and also give you an idea about the expected cutoff according to the paper and the difficulty level. So please watch this video till the end because this video is going to set up your preparation strategy for the upcoming NET exam. And also those of you who've given the exam, I'm pretty sure you must be very curious inside and some of you must be wondering that, okay, my paper went well, what about others? Somebody who is not so good with the paper might have felt that, okay, my world has fallen apart, I don't know what to do and there's no sense of sitting for the next NET exam. So for all those, I would just like to tell you that it was just one paper. Don't lose hope, don't think that the world has fallen apart. I'm pretty sure that you're going to nail it next time if you have not done this time. And for those who've done exceptionally well in the paper, I would like to congratulate you and tell you that we are very, very confident that you're going to ace it this time. So people who have not performed so well in paper one, they must be disheartened. I would be talking about the paper in this video. I would be talking about different sections and what kind of difficulty level was there. But before that, just a small advice for all those who think that their paper did not went well as per their expectation. Just understand this thing that a paper cannot tell whether you are smart enough or not. It doesn't tell whether you are intelligent or not. It is just a paper and the loopholes that you've done in your preparation that are highlighted when the paper comes in front of you. So just go slow, concentrate on the mistakes and try to improve yourself. That is how you're going to succeed next time. So without wasting any more time, let's jump right into the paper and let's see what kind of questions were asked from each of the sections. To analyze the paper properly, I have jotted down the different questions which students have told me and I have jotted down in different areas so that I can analyze each of these sections and tell you exactly what I think about and what would be the expected cutoff. So we'll begin with teaching aptitude. Now teaching aptitudes at this time, there were two major questions which students somehow faced difficulty in. One was about the level of cognitive interchange. Now if you remember my video on teaching aptitude, I have actually told you that this is a very important section because in that section are the three major levels and this time a question was asked from memory level. Another important question that came was talking about what do you mean by good teaching methodology? Is it proactive? Is it practical? It is pragmatic? What is it? So if you look at the other questions of teaching aptitude, you'll figure out that the questions are very common sense based. Okay, you don't need to actually read encyclopedias to answer those questions. If you can just use your little brain, and also elimination is a beautiful technique. I keep on talking about elimination whenever I talk about how to solve MCQs properly. So there are four options. You need to cut down the options which you think are not right, compare two options and then strike out the option which you think is not so correct when compared to the other option, and the final option becomes the right answer. Those are the same method you have to employ whenever you are solving teaching aptitude questions. Coming on to the next section, which is reading comprehension. Now, all the students who've given this paper in the first shift have told me that the reading comprehension was very, very simple. The language was so simple and so understandable that they could just read it in one flow. They didn't have to make an effort to understand it. Even the questions were quite easy, but a few students have told me that somewhere they had to put in a little effort to understand which of the options would be right. Because obviously, if the passage is simple, they are going to make the questions a little harder. Coming on to the third section, which is data interpretation. Guys, you were lucky if you sat for December 6th first shift for paper 1 because the reading comprehension as well as data interpretation, they were super, super cool. Data interpretation ka jo table tha, that table had numbers which were very simple to calculate. You don't even need a pen paper to add all those numbers. You can do it in your head. It was so simple. The figures were given in crores, but then the figures were very simple. 120, 70, 90, these were the figures. So basically the data interpretation table talked about three companies and the export that they have made in different years from 2012 to 17. And the questions were based on the table. So the questions were very simple. Students have told told me that they didn't have to actually add anything, as in put any formula in order to get the answer. They were like very simple. You just need to add, subtract, and finally figure out the difference between 2012 and 14, sort of that, or compare company A with B. That's it. You don't have to actually calculate percentage change or growth rate or anything of that sort, which sometimes are very typical for students. So data interpretation was also very easy. Coming on to the next section, which I think scares most of the students, which is logical reasoning and mathematical reasoning. Now, logical reasoning says, but the questions I, they were theoretical. Okay, they were asking questions about premise. They were asking questions about valid and invalid argument. They were also asking questions about deductive fallacy, which was a different topic, which was never asked before as far as English literature's paper one is concerned. So this was a slightly challenging thing for students, but then they said that overall the questions were very simple. Also, they told me that there were no questions from syllogism or Venn diagram, which was surprising. No questions at all. So most of the questions were focused on the theoretical aspect when it comes to logical reasoning. The same thing they told about Indian logic. So there was a question on Anupalabdhi, which was pretty easy. If you guys have watched my video on Indian logic, I'm pretty sure you must have answered it correctly. Also, there was a question which was from Vedic education. So we all know that in Indian culture, Indian society, there are different samskars which a student has to go through in his entire life. A person, not even a student, a normal person. So, vivaah ka ek panigrah sanskar hota hai. Isi tarah ke kafi sare sanskar hote hain. One of the sanskar is related to education. So, the question was that which of the sanskar is related to education. So, if you are interested in Indian mythology, just like I am, I'm pretty sure the question would have been a very easy one for you. Coming on to mathematical reasoning. Now, mathematical reasoning se is baar jo questions aaye hain, usme students ne kaha hai, they were pretty easy. Some of them who are very afraid of maths, they told that the questions were from different areas. Student reported that there were no questions from alphabetical series or from permutation combination, but this time more focus was given to 8th 9th standard maths. So one very interesting question was of course number series, which was pretty easy for a lot of students. You just had to do the cubes and the square roots and also add or subtract few numbers from it in order to get the answer, which was easy. Another important question that was asked was ratio. So father and son's age were given and you have to calculate the ratio. So a question which I have already explained in my videos that you have to concentrate on. There is a very, very good chance that the question is going to come up in the exam. Another important question which came this time and was missing in the last year's paper, last June's paper, was the square and cube roots. So if you look at the question said that you have been given the length of the cube and then you have to figure out that if the length is increased, what would be the change in the area. So this was a slightly different question, but the student said that the length was 5 centimeters. So I think we all know the area formula for a square, that is L square. So you can easily figure out that. Another question was about integers. So they asked us that which integer is the smallest who is also a cube root as well as a square root of any of the other integers. So you have to figure out that kaun sa aisa integer hai jo kisi aur number ka cube root bhi hai aur square root bhi hai. So I think that it's basic maths. If you know, if you were good at 8th 9th standard maths, I think you can pretty well score in this particular section. Coming on to the next section, which is communication. So students told me that from communication, they focus so much on classroom communication. There were hardly one question. I think one was about the encoder, decoder, the entire communication channel. That's it. Apart from that, all the other questions were actually about classroom communication. Next is of course research, which is another horrifying topic. Now from research this time there were no questions from types of hypothesis, types of variables. There were more questions on steps of research. Also there were questions on sampling. So there was a question that if there's a heterogeneous group, then which will be the best possible sampling technique that you can use. Now for research, I've always been telling my students that the best way is to go through any one book where you can get some material on research, because see, all the other topics are common sense based, but when it comes to research, you have to put in a little effort and know the terminology. So unless and until you're not acquainted with the terminology, you cannot solve these questions. There was another question on t-test and chi-square. So t-test, chi-square, these are unknown terms for most of the students. If you don't know it, then how are you going to solve it? For me, it has always been an easier topic because in my bachelor's, I had psychology, and in psychology, one compulsory subject was research. So I've always been a research scholar. Now, coming on to the next topic, which is computer, that is IT. From computers, I've always been telling you that if you are good at computers, if you know what is the technology all about, some common terms like URL, www, then you don't have to really read anything. And the same thing happened this time also. There were very basic questions. Audio files ke formats kaun kaun se hote, MP3, what all. So if you have actually gone through your playlist in your mobile phone, you must have seen that there are songs which are in AVI, there are songs which are in MP3. So these are different formats. Another interesting question was on binary and byte. So there was a question, assertion reason question, where they asked about binary calculation and they also asked about what makes one byte. So 8 bits make one byte. So very common thing. Another question was on optical fiber, URL, and some other important computer related terms. So optical fiber, I think that once Jio has come into the market, we all know what optical fiber actually is. And URL is like a very, very simple term, uniform resource locator. If you have actually gone to the internet and searched anything, you must be aware that what you do is you're working with URLs. So computer, of course, another very, very easy segment. You must be thinking that Arpita has been saying that all the sections were easy. But what can I do, guys? All my students have done such an amazing job that, you know, that's the report I've got. And when I go through the questions also, which students have been telling me, I have almost got an idea that the paper was very, very simple. And since the paper is simple, we are expecting that a lot of students are going to really do good in the paper. Coming on to the next section, which is people and environment. Now, people and environment, say this time there were no questions from current affairs. Static GK pucha gaya tha. Now, with static GK, I mean simple terms, renewable, non-renewable, natural hazards and all that stuff. This time I made a video a few days back that what should you study if you want to get good marks in people and environment. And in that video, I told you that please focus on renewable resources because they focus so much on these topics these days. And this time there was a question from biomass. So they were asking that biomass is known as carbon neutral resource. Why? You have to answer that. Another question was about natural hazard. They were asking that which is the natural hazard which is slowest in their rate of occurrence. So it's of course drought. Okay, achanak se akal nahi padta hai, dheere dheere akal ki paristhiti aati hai. Another question was of Kyoto Protocol. Now, Kyoto Protocol, I've been telling you, Montreal, Kyoto Protocol, these are some of the most important ones. You have to know what they were about, when they happened, and what were the major changes these protocols talked about. One question was on renewable resource. You have to tell which of the four is a renewable resource. So you have to identify the correct one. So another simple thing, but yes, of course, there are things which you must focus on. And that is the reason I keep on telling my students to continuously watch the YouTube videos where I keep on updating the most frequently or the most commonly asked questions for UGC NET paper 1. And finally, we come on to the last section, which was higher education. Another interesting section which scares a lot of students. This month, I also made a video on higher education where I told that you don't need to focus at all at the government sector because they're asking a lot more questions from higher education rather than focusing on fundamental duties, rights, president, prime minister, supreme court and all that stuff. And this is what happened in the paper. They were asking a lot of questions from higher education section, but to my surprise, they did not ask any question on central universities or which was the university which was appreciated in 2019. They were focusing on the bodies of higher education or they were talking about some programs. Like they asked about the National Skill Ministry, Development Ministry has a flagship program. They asked the name of that program. So this was overall paper. I've tried to gather as many questions as I could from my students so that I can give you an idea that what the paper was all about. And now we are going to talk about the expected cutoff. So see, cutoff obviously is determined by how you perform in paper 1 and 2. Since I've not yet analyzed paper 2, I would just be sharing my cutoff for paper 1. So for paper 1, I think that if you are an average student, if you're not so good at paper 1, and if you are not so bad at paper 1, then somewhere around 30 to 35 marks would be a good score out of 50. Okay, if you calculate it as 2 marks per question, then of course it would rise. So if you are somewhere getting 30 to 35 questions right out of 50, that means it's a pretty nice score. And if you're absolutely brilliant at paper 1, then I think the paper was such that you can even score 40 above out of 50. I'll soon be analyzing paper 2, December 6, shift 1. So stay tuned to my channel. Also, if you've not yet subscribed to the channel, you should do it, because I'm going to post all the latest UGC NET updates very soon on my channel. You should also follow me on social media, because all the news, when is the corrected mark sheet coming, or when is the question paper getting on the UGC site, or when the result is being declared, I'm going to post all of that information on my Facebook and Instagram. So make sure you subscribe my YouTube channel, and also follow me on Instagram and Facebook if you've not done it. So that's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.